Saving a high score over a span of several game sessions is very easy and can be done using Unity's player prefs. In this tutorial, I will show you how to save a simple point value and how to show this value in your UI as a high score. There will also be another part where I show you how to handle a list of high scores together with the names of players. Now let's start! Currently, our points increase every second while in play mode. To define a start and end point, I'll add two buttons. One which will start the game and therefore the point counter, and one for the end. This will end the counting and check for a new high score. I create an empty game object as a wrapper for the buttons and place it at the bottom. To your wrapper, the parent element of your buttons, you can add a horizontal layout group, which will set the children's position. I'll change the alignment to middle center, and the buttons will now be equally spreaded. For the button handling, I add a script called GameHandler. In there, I define two public methods, which will be used from the buttons. In here, that's fine for now. Inside the point counter script we created in the first episode, I rename the default start method to start game, so the point counting won't start on game start anymore, but rather when this method is called. I also add a stop game method, like in the previous script, and a boolean I call game stopped. This will be a new condition for our while loop. As long as this value is false, the loop will go on. Inside the stop game method, I will set this boolean to true, and therefore the while loop with its counting will stop. Now let's complete the game handler. At first, I need a reference to a point counter script. At this point, a singleton would be really handy, but since we keep this simple, I add a serialized field so that we can add the reference via the inspector. Now in the start game and the stop game methods, we can call the newly created methods from the point counter script. Back in Unity, make sure to add your game handler script to your scene, like I did this with the manager object. And also fill the reference. Now inside our buttons, I add the onClick event. Drag and drop the object where your game handler script is located down into the object slot. Now look for your script name and in there your method name. Do this for both of your buttons. When I now test the game, you can see that I can start the game and then stop it. In this case, 40 would be our high score. So let's implement the fun stuff now. At first, we need some UI. I add an empty game object as wrapper and move it to the top left. To make sure everyone knows that this will be the high score, I'll also add some text. I duplicate the text object and add an example number for our real high score number. Again, if you add a horizontal layout group to the wrapper, your elements will be placed next to each other. I change the alignment to the center. And if you want to get rid of the spacing between those two, you just need to disable the Child Force Expand checkbox in Width. But for a high score way too small, let me increase the size a little bit. Now, that's not bad. So, again, like in the point counting tutorials, I'll separate the logic from the UI. I create a new script which will be responsible for storing and updating the current high score value if there is a new one. A simple integer will always represent the current active high score. Inside the default start method, I will call another method which is responsible for setting the latest high score from the saved ones. We are going to use the player prefs for this value. Player prefs is a class that stores player preferences between game sessions. It can store string, float, and integer values into the user's platform registry. So you can easily store simple key value pairs in your player prefs, which will then be stored inside of your OS registry. For complex cases, this approach is not recommended. But for now, let's go with this. With the getInt method, we will get an integer with the key name highScore. If this is empty, we want a default value of 0. I save the response in our Highscore variable. I create a new method called saveHighscore. This will simply save the Highscore integer variable to the player prefs. Therefore, we use the setInt method and use the exact same name like above in our getInt call. So the key must match. In this case, the second parameter is the value we want to set. Instead of using the variable we defined at the top of our class, I use a parameter for this method. This makes this method more flexible, and you don't have to be extra careful to only call this one after replacing the Highscore variable with the new value. Now we need a public method, which will be called whenever our game has ended and there could be a new Highscore. It's up to this Highscore handler to check if the reached value is a new Highscore or not. As parameter, there will be the reached score. We will check if the reached score is greater than our current Highscore. If it is, we will replace the Highscore variable with the new one. To make sure the new value will be saved, we also need to call the saveHighscore method and add the current score as parameter. And don't forget to call the setLatestHighscore method in the start method. This will set the initial value. Great, now we just need to call the setHighscoreIfGreater method whenever our game ended. So let's switch to the game handler. Here we need two new references to other scripts. Of course we need the HighscoreHandler script, because this is where we call the method. But in this case, we also need a reference to the pointHeart script, because this is where our current point value is saved, which will we then pass to the Highscore validation method. In the stop method, we can now add this function call. As parameter, I'll use this public pointGetter from the pointHeart script. We created this earlier in this tutorial series, so if you made anything different, make sure to add the current reference to your point value. Great, now we can test this. Add your new script to your manager object and set all the references. Unfortunately, we won't see anything because we didn't implement the UI yet. But this won't stop us. Inside your inspector, where your Highscore handler script is located, just click at those three dots and select debug. This will make our Highscore integer variable visible, even if it is private. Let's start the game. You can see nothing happens to the variable, which is what we want. But when we stop, the current Highscore of 0 gets replaced with the new Highscore of 35. When I now stop the play mode and then start it again, you can see it will initially set to 35. So the saving inside the player prefs also works nicely. If the reached points are lower than the Highscore, it won't be overwritten. Our main logic works. Great. Now we can add the UI handling inside a new script. I create one and call it HighscoreUI. Like we did in the pointHeart script, I add a reference to the text component from the Highscore. Make sure to add the UnityEngine.UI package at the top. I then add a public method, which is responsible to override the UI text with the parameter value. Just change the text of your text variable to the score variable and convert it to a string with the toString method of integers. There's not much more here to do. Now we just need to call this method whenever a new Highscore gets applied inside the Highscore handler. Of course, at first we need a reference to the script. After we set a new Highscore successfully, we will call the setHighscore method with the current score as parameter. But we will also need to call this initially after the load of the saved Highscore. Now this would become a bit messy. Let's improve it. I add a setter for the Highscore integer variable. Whenever this setter is called, we can now update the UI. Since the setter is public, I named it like our variable, but with a capital first letter. Now just replace every assignment to the Highscore variable with the new setter, with the capital first letter. We use this approach also for our points. Now, whenever the Highscore setter is called, we will save the updated value. This is very well maintainable, especially for future changes in your code. So, now we just need to add the script to our manager object and assign all the references. Make sure to add the correct text component as well. And now, let's test it. You can see, the Highscore number was just updated to the 35 we had earlier. I stop the game at 45 and the Highscore value gets updated immediately. That's it. The Highscore UI script looks still empty now, but since we divided logic and UI, you can fill this with some cool animations and you don't have to touch your Highscore saving logic anymore. In the next episode, I'll show you how to create, update and save a list of Highscores with their player names. This is far more complex, because we are going to store the data as a JSON. So there will be a tutorial about this beforehand. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the content, consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you next time.